In Psalm 41 through 3, King David had been rescued by God. It says, I waited patiently for the Lord. Have we not been waiting? And are we not still continuing to wait? I waited patiently for the Lord. He turned to me and heard my cry. He lifted me out of the pit of destruction, out of the sticky mud. He stood me on a rock and made my feet steady. He put a new song in my mouth, a song of praise to our God. Many people will see this and worship him. Then they will trust the Lord. I want us to go back over that real quickly. I waited patiently for the Lord. We must wait on the Lord. Just because we want things done the way we want them done, immediately on our time schedule, sometimes God says you've got to wait. Sometimes God says we have to wait on him. And so wait patiently for the Lord. He turned to me and heard my cry. We know God hears our cry, but he also at some point will reveal that he has heard our cry. He has heard our plea. And that will be assuring to us. In verse 2 it says, he lifted me up out of the pit of destruction. Do you not kind of feel that way today? That all the chaos that's going on around our country, through our country, and around the world is like a pit of destruction. Not only just because of what we're facing today, but just in the reality of the darkness of sin and the progressiveness of society to embrace everything that's ungodly. And yet God has called us to stand strong and to rely on him, that he will lift us up out of the pit of destruction, out of the sticky mud. You feel that way? Feel stuck in the sticky mud, the grime? I feel that way. I feel like I'm stuck in a circumstance I have no control over. You know what? I don't. But God does. God does. He stood me on a rock and made my feet steady. We don't have to feel overwhelmed. We don't have to feel that we are being dominated and robbed. But what we can do is rely on him and stand on the rock and be made steady in him. Because that steadiness was reflected with Paul and Silas. Paul and Silas continued the steadiness of their faith in God, their stand on him, their dependence on him, the trust that whatever he allowed for a reason, and they were willing to be used as a testimony to God. He put a new song in my mouth. Isn't that wonderful? We're talking about praising God. They're praising God, they were praising God in the dungeon or in the prison. David was praising God with a new song. He's saying, David's saying, look, out of all the horrible stuff I was in, I was like stuck in mud and I had no hope. You pulled me out of the sticky mud. You put me on top of a rock. You brushed me off. You made me steady. You made me secure. You gave me what I needed, and you put a new song on my mouth. Don't be afraid to create your own song, you know, and worship the Lord. He put a new song in my mouth, a song of praise to our God. Many people will see this and worship him, then they will trust the Lord. Isn't that what we want to see? That people will see the song in our heart, the joy in our heart, the security we have, the stance that we have in Christ, and our total surrender to trust God. It's those type of perspectives, those type of viewpoints that will enable us to help us to focus as we ought to be able to have the right thinking during difficult times. His rescue by God would not only cause him to worship, but it would cause others to worship as well. Others would come to know Christ, as I said. Others would come to put their faith in the God of David. Others would come to put their faith in Jesus Christ, our Savior, who is God in the flesh. And so we need to remember that our witness will have an effect that will bring honor and glory to God if our focus and heart is fixed as God would have it to be. And so when we praise him for this, we praise him publicly. You know, and we can share in here, we can share testimonies, we can encourage each other as brothers and sisters in Christ whenever we're together, but that is not sharing publicly. And by that, we need to be willing to share with those that God brings into our lives. And not hold back and say, God did something for me today. I want to tell you about it. And just reflect on that. And let them hear the reality of the life of Jesus in us. When we praise God for what he's done, we share God publicly, and we cause what is the horizontal effect of worship. You and I can worship God one-on-one, any day, any moment, any minute, any time. But to worship God horizontally is what we're doing right now. But it's not constricted to right now in here. It's meant to go beyond these four walls. It's meant to go out into the lives of the people that God brings into our lives, that they might see Jesus in us.